Good evening, everyone. I'll be discussing the transportation problem here. First, I'll be discussing how to solve a particular problem by using a Vogel's approximation method. And because this is the method which gives you the solution which is closest to the optimum solution. So if you see this particular problem right here, first you need to understand the problem. There are four markets and there are three plants in this particular problem. And these are the costs which are associated. That means if I am supplying, let's say, one unit from plant P1 to market M2, then the cost is 2 rupees. So you can multiply it by 10,000 or lakhs, depending on what the transportation cost is. So one thing is clear, that you can reduce the matrix to minimum number. That means if all numbers are divisible by 100, and so you can divide all the numbers by 100, and you can get smaller numbers for faster calculation. These are the availabilities with the plants. Plant 1, P1 has 15 units available with it, P2 has 25 units, P3 has 10 units available with it, while four markets have different demands with 5, 15, 15 and 15. So this total sums up to 50, both sides. That means demand as well as requirement as well as availability. If this mismatches, that means availability is more or demand is more. In that case, the transportation problem is unbalanced transportation problem. So we need to convert it into a balanced transportation problem, and then only we can solve it. So this is a balanced transportation problem. I have 50 units available with me, and apart from that, the requirement in the markets is also 50. So number of units are same. So I can straight away go and solve this particular problem. So the method which I'll be using to solve this particular problem is VAM, Vogel's approximation method. So this is the method which I'll be using. So in order to solve Vogel's approximation method, what first we have to do is we have to calculate penalties with respect to rows as well as with respect to columns. So how do we do that? I'm writing row penalties at P1 and column penalties as P1 dash, the first penalty. So when I talk about first row penalty, I have to see minimum and second minimum cost. So minimum cost is 2 and second minimum cost is 10. So the difference is 8. Now the thing is, so many times people ask that if I am getting 2 2s, that means it is 2, 2, 20 and 11, then what I should choose? Then actually the minimum is 2 and the second minimum will become 11. This is a different case that two minimums are tying up. Alright, so in that case, you have to select always minimum and second minimum, find the difference of them. That will be known as the penalty. Now, apart from that, I will suggest that this is the solution table, how should you make it. If you can see that I have put all the cost in the top left corners, so the allocations can be made easy. Now, in second, 7 and 9 are two minimum and second minimums, then the difference comes out to be 2. In third particular row, the minimum is 4 and the second minimum is 14, and this difference comes out to be 10. Similarly, I'll calculate these penalties in the column. It will be 10 minus 4, which gives me 6. Then it will be 7 minus 2, which is going to give me 5. And then it is going to be 9 minus 16, which is going to give me 7. And then it is 18 minus 11, which is again going to give me 7. So once I calculated penalties, I have to see maximum out of all. That means in entire row penalties as well as in column penalties. In column penalties and row penalties, I have to see maximum. Maximum is this 10. This is a decider. From here, I should enter the matrix. So in this particular row, I have to see the minimum cost cell, which is right here at 4. So I have to allocate minimum of supply and demand. So if you see in this particular cell, the minimum of supply and demand is between 10 and 5. The minimum is 5. Right, so I have to, what I can do is, while I'm calculating second penalties, if you see this market was in requirement of 5 units, all 5 units are allocated. So I cannot allocate anything in this particular market, so it goes out. Now I'll be calculating second penalty here. So this I will not be calculating. If you see the remaining column penalties, they are going to remain absolutely same. They will not change, they are going to be 5. Again, second minimum and second minimum I am calculating, while row will change because this particular row column will not be considered, because market M1 was having demand of 5 units, which has completely been satisfied. Now my minimum is 2 and second minimum is 11, so the difference comes out to be 9. Now my minimum, second, 7 and 9, that remains 2, and out of these 3, my minimum is 14 and 16, difference comes out to be 2. Again, I'll search for maximum, which is this particular 9. So I enter from this particular column right here. The minimum cost cell is this 2, In this, I'll be allocating minimum of supply and demand. That means out of 15 and 15, both are same. So I have this flexibility, I can allocate 15 units here. So when I'll be calculating third penalties, I don't have to calculate this. And third penalty similarly, P3 dash here, not this. And in fact, this is 15, this is also done. And now I'll be calculating these remaining two penalties. In this case, I'll not be considering row 1 because I have already crossed this particular row. So the minimum, in fact, I'm left only with two options, 19 and 6 here. The 7 is the difference, and 18 and 20, the 2 is the difference. And here, of course, I'll not be considering these two columns, and I'll be considering only these two. So 20 minus 9 comes out to be 11, and 16 minus 18 comes out to be 2. So now I see the maximum lies here, 11. So I enter from this 11 and I see the minimum cost cell because these two markets have already been allocated. So I have to see minimum of 9 and 20, which is this 9. Again, I can allocate 50, which is minimum of supply and demand. So when I calculate penalty number 4, I don't have to calculate 1. And in P3 dash, in fact, I should not calculate 1, 2 and 3. So anyways, I'm left with 20 and 18 because all three columns are already done with. And here I'm left with 2. So this is the maximum number, again 20. I enter from here. This is the only option which I'm left with. So I cannot allocate more than 10. 15 plus 10 is 25. So I'm going to cross it out. And then this is also done. Then what I'm left with is the last particular cell, of course, which you can see already in P5. So I'm left only with this 18, and here exactly, this was P4 dash, then I'm going to put in P5 dash, not in need, not in need, not in need, only this cell is, particular cell is left. So allocation I can do is 5. So I think now, this penalty was 18. Now if you see, if you start calculating, P6, then I am done with all of them. Similarly, if you see, I do P6 here, I don't need anything. And the allocation is complete. Now I have to see what are these, how many number of allocations I have. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 allocations in this particular case. So how do I find out whether this is a degenerate transportation problem or not? I have to see whether number of allocations are equal to m plus n minus 1, which is row plus column minus 1. So my number of allocations are 5. And how many rows I have? I have 3 rows plus how many columns I have? 4 columns minus 1. So 4 plus 3 minus 1 is 6. So this is not equal. That means number of allocations are less than. So what exactly is here? Number of allocations are less than equal to m plus n minus 1. Therefore, the problem is degenerate. So I'll be covering how to remove degeneracy, how to check the optimality in the next video. Thank you.